Okay, so welcome to our April student support staff meeting for the Health eWorkforce Consortium.
Welcome, Esther.
Hi, we just walked in the door. So just briefly to go over our agenda today, I was going to give a little update on the veteran recruiting I'm doing at Joint Base Lewis-McChord. And just talk about veteran recruiting in general. We'll have some time to share challenges and best practices. Want to get your feedback on the LinkedIn employment group that's been up and running for the last few weeks. Also, we'll have a round of commitments, a couple reminders, and talk about our future format and meetings. So you should have all received an email from me last week or the week before last announcing that I'm now 2 days a week on base at Joint Base Lewis-McChord. That's me at my little desk there. really I just wanted to talk a little bit about my work there and then how I will be working with you guys to hand off any students who are interested in your program. So really my role is to recruit for all of the Health eWorkforce Consortium programs. And the goal in general is just to increase our percentage of service members, veterans, and spouses in our program. Hello, Adriana. My office hours there are Mondays and Thursdays. My actual in-office hours on Thursdays are a little later, 11 to 3, because I'm attending the advising staff meeting there in the morning on Thursdays. And you can go to the next slide. And so really, what I'm going to be doing there is really just outreach and recruiting with folks, giving them information about the grant and about our programs, kind of finding out what programs they're interested in, hopefully doing some information sessions, meeting with people one-on-one, and just kind of being the presence there on base to represent the consortium. The process I came up with for actually how to work on this is, you know, that I will be the initial point of contact to welcome people into Health IT, provide the program information, determine their interests, collect their contact information, start a record of contact, and then hand off to the appropriate navigator at the member colleges depending on what program they're interested in. And the way I see that happening is really, we want this to be a really easy and smooth process for them to make it really clear and to try to avoid confusion. So the idea is, after I make that initial contact with them, to either introduce them to you through email or actually through a three-way phone call. And then what I would like to see happen after that is just that I be included on the follow-up contact with them, whether it's just CCing me on the email or giving me a call and letting me know what happened. Whether they actually enrolled or didn't, and then I'll follow up later actually to get feedback from you and from them as well. So are there any questions about that?
What kind of interest are you getting? Are you seeing a lot of interest or not so much?
So right now, I've really just been getting settled. I've only been there 3 days, actually, on base. So getting set up, meeting all of the advising staff, and trying to find ways to get the word out that I'm there and where I am, and then also distributing brochures. So I haven't actually met with anyone yet, but they are taking our brochures, which is a good sign. So the front desk staff actually asked for 150 brochures. So one of the things I'll be doing is, you know, kind of labeling those brochures so that they know where to find me and how to contact me. We're putting a posting on their Facebook page for the Stone Center, and then some banners and signage to kind of direct people to me. So I don't have any answer to your question yet because I haven't actually had any one-on-one meetings with anyone yet.
Yeah, no, that makes sense. But I know setting things up is a long process, so.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's kind of like starting a new job in a way.
Exactly.
A little bit to settle in and get to know everyone. So.
I think it's great that you're out there.
Yeah, it's pretty exciting. I don't know if any of you have ever been to the Stone Education Center, but it's a really nice facility. Lots of universities are present there. Pierce College has a big presence there. And I think they said there are 1 million soldiers come through there a year who are transitioning. So, and there are a lot of people. Now it's just how to get them to me.
Could you see there be a benefit of having individual brochures or information from different certificate programs?
Yeah, actually, I think.
How many?
Good question. So Shannon asked if there'd be a benefit to having specific program brochures, and that is one of the things I wanted to talk about, is if you already have updated marketing materials that you could send me that you would like distributed there, go ahead and send them to me here in Bellevue. And as far as the number, I mean, I would say maybe start with 50. So I know programs are constantly being updated and changed. So, and then what I would really like to do is create a one-page kind of information sheet for each program so that they're somewhat in the same format for people, so that when I'm meeting with them, it's really clear and confusing, and not confusing, and the information's all like in the same place. So that's something I'm going to be working on. Based on right now, I'm working off what you guys provided in the inventory, as well as your website and any brochures I have, and our consortium brochure. So that's my main marketing piece right now, is the consortium brochure and a PowerPoint that I put together. Any other questions? Any concerns? Okay, great. Well, you know, I hope this will be a good thing. I mean, I'm confident that it will be once we get settled in, so I'll keep you updated. So then my question for all of you is, what are you doing at each of your member colleges to recruit service members and veterans and spouses? And just like to open it up for sharing and discussion. Looks like we had some comments in the chat box that I missed. Matt Bryan said it would be helpful to have more informational materials.
He's asking.
Oh, would it be? Okay, we covered that. And then from Matt as well, our efforts to recruit veteran participants have been focused on maintaining an active connection with our on-campus veterans clubs and through contributing to the efforts of our on-campus veterans committees. And Adriana said, we are also working with our Veteran Resource Center and have created a new infographic marketing flyer to distribute. We attend fairs and working groups as well as outside.
Here at Bellevue College, it's the same. I'm attending veterans WorkSource events, as well as I've been asked to present at a student informational session for veterans about our program next week.
Great. So is anyone else doing anything other than meeting with WorkSource, Veterans Clubs, and Veterans Resource Centers on campus?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. We work with our main veteran guy, Jared, and then knowing which programs they most go into, veterans typically try and major in, are our computer scientist program, so then I get to go in there and just speak to the class, knowing that there's a large portion of veterans, and then highlight how the grant benefits veterans and how it's a focus. So that's the main thing we're doing right now.
Great, thanks. Sounds like a great idea. Okay, let's go ahead to the next slide. So this is where we get to open it up to just talk about any challenges or best practices that you'd like to share with the group. How about Bellevue? Did you guys bring any?
One of the outreach groups that we've had some success with, and we are being asked to sponsor, are some of the meetup groups like Health2O and Seattle Innovators, where there's a large community of entrepreneurs who are in health IT, and so letting them know about our program. We'll also be doing a sponsorship for a local nursing association and be giving a presentation. So that's one area.
Great.
And also, we wanted to comment that PAM for our group, our Bellevue College team members, helped us with a SWOT analysis of our three certificate programs, looking at the advantages, challenges, and just a great opportunity to brainstorm and determine next steps.
Glad you guys found that helpful.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So, just in case you don't know what a SWOT analysis is, strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. And essentially, we went through each of the HIT certificate programs at Bellevue to kind of see where they were and how we could leverage strengths and capitalize on opportunities. So, I'm happy to work with any of you do the same with your programs. If you're interested, just let me know. Contact me.
So one of the things, this is Esther from Bellevue, and one of the things that came out of our SWOT analysis for the CA HIMSS program was to have a meeting with Spokane Community College that Pam facilitated for us. And they gave us a really good idea to go into some courses that we hadn't initially thought about going into. And when I reached out to the program, they were very enthusiastic. And we've got plans now to go into, I'd say, a half a dozen different courses to talk about the CA HIMSS program. So Spokane's had a lot of luck with with that marketing strategy, and we're hoping that we'll have the same sort of luck. So for us, the SWOT analysis really allowed us to talk about the kinds of things that were important to us about the certificate programs and about marketing them. So if anybody is kind of, if you're out there kind of thinking, what else can we do, having Pam work with you on that, I think, would be really helpful.
Thanks, Esther. Yeah. Looks like we have some comments in the chat box. So from Matt Bryant, the best practice he wanted to share is participating in general entry advising functions to recruit students for the health IT program. Matt, do you want to say anything more about that?
Sure. Sorry, I just had to unmute. So lately I've been doing what we're calling lunch with an advisor. And I sit in the cafeteria every day for an hour and provide general advising to any students who inquire. A lot of those folks are new or prospective students who are looking at their program options, and it gives me an opportunity to present Health IT as an option to them. And just today I had a gentleman who's currently a computer networking student, and he was interested in taking some classes over the summer. And it was a perfect opportunity for me to pitch our summer add-on certificate, which allows computer networking students specifically to take these three summer classes to add our certificate. So I've had a lot of good opportunities like that as a result of my participation in general advising functions.
That's great. Thanks for sharing that.
Yeah.
And it looks like Adriana shared a best practice as well. Let's see, a film and workshop.
Film
a workshop and have
the
link.
Yeah, so I can share with that.
Okay, thanks.
So recently I thought it would make sense to film some workshops, and there's something if anyone uses Canvas, I'm sure Moodle or some of the online course shells are similar, where you can actually film directly in there. Tegrity is what it's called on Canvas. So with that, if you, because we have the webcam on the laptop, it can record right there. And then if a student misses it, instead of, you know, repeating the information over and over, you can give them the link. So just an idea of something to try out, just to kind of have it more in an online format.
Okay, great. Thanks.
I'll go ahead and share a challenge.
Okay.
One of our programs, our nursing programs, has a lot of hands-on advising within their department. And so I have a few students who use me as a resource, but I think a challenge I'm having is finding out at the end of the quarter that there's a couple of students, different ones each time, who struggled during the past quarter. And since they're so encouraged to use their nursing advisors, it's a challenge trying to get that buy-in again that I might be a non-faculty member that they could turn to without, you know, wondering if it'll look bad upon them. So I don't quite know how to navigate that right now to make sure they know they can still come to me when they're encouraged to go to their faculty if they have academic challenges.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Natalie, this is Jennifer Hemker from Bellevue College. I had a question on that. Do the faculty in the nursing department refer students that are struggling to you? Like, is that typically how they come to you?
No. Other programs do. We have four different ones, and the nursing program is so self-sustained that I send out my newsletters, and a few will come to me if there's something that strikes them. But for academic things, kind of not in that loop, still trying to get my foothold.
Function the same way here, it sounds like.
Okay. Gotcha.
Interesting. Okay. Thank you for sharing that.
This is Adriana, and I know with our nursing faculty, they are very closed off. So it did take quite a while for me to win them over, basically.
<Gotcha. laughs>
So one thing I did was I put kind of, I went to a faculty meeting, so with all the different nurse faculty were there, and I just told them what my service is, and I clarified my role. Like, I'm not trying to take students away from you, I'm not trying to step on your toes, but these are additional supplemental things that I can offer you and that I'd want to help out with, and I tried to find things that they needed. So, for example, I decided I would offer an APA format workshop because the students all use that, and they were having problems. Students were getting in trouble for plagiarism, and I said, okay, I'm going to offer this on campus because it's something they need. And then a lot of them went, okay, great, you're filling a need for us. And I said, and students can also come individually, and I can help them with that. So if there's any way you can look or ask them what would help you, what bring a list of topics and say, what would you not want to help the students with? Maybe they don't want to help them with NCLEX prep or test taking or note taking, or maybe there's something that you can kind of fulfill that and help them out and just clarify that your role is just additional support, whatever they might need, basically.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you. That makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, Adriana. Mm-hmm. Is that helpful, Natalie?
It was. I'll give that a definite try this week or next week.
Okay. If anyone else has any ideas that come to them, please send them to Natalie. Anyone who hasn't shared, would anyone like to share who hasn't shared? Okay, next slide, please. Okay, so the next item on the agenda is to talk about the new LinkedIn employment group that I've started. This was really started as a place for me to be able to share information with you guys as it becomes available and also to share job postings. So I'm wondering, are you guys using it? Are you finding it helpful? Or are there things that you're not seeing on there that you would like to see on there? Or any other feedback that you have on the LinkedIn group?
I like it. I like seeing the updates, but it's just the usual, you know, tucked up here in Bellingham. Most of the job postings are for, you know, South Puget Sound, Seattle area. So as you see Bellingham, Whatcom-type jobs, kick them our way.
Okay. So, actually, just to let you know, I am checking in Bellingham.
I know. It's a tight market.
Any jobs up there.
Exactly.
Matt had a comment.
I also found the job fairs, especially if they were industry-specific, helpful. That's something that we can pass on to students.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, great. I really, my hope is that a lot of the information I'm posting there that you will then be able to funnel on to your students, especially the job fairs and the job postings. I guess my other question would be, in terms of jobs, are there certain jobs or certain programs that you're wanting to see more job postings for? I mean, other than just more in general, but is there anything specific? And then the last thing is just I want to encourage you to feel free to post on that site as well, to post resources and to share and to start discussions. So it's not just for me to post things. Okay. So Adriana said it's nice to have it all in one place. I work with nursing and pharmacy tech students, so any jobs in those areas are helpful. Okay. Thank you.
And another thing that would be really helpful is if we know of good places like to look for nursing jobs or pharmacy tech jobs or radiologic technology jobs, go ahead and post them on that site, and then the rest of us can, you know, refer our students to them as well, because we may not know about a particular site that you like to send your students to.
So I think the request was for other sites, mm-hmm. like Indeed or Monster or ones that we don't know about maybe, that, you know, what are the different sites that you're sending students to look for jobs?
Yep.
I think that would be a great discussion to start, and maybe we'll all get some new ideas from that. Thanks, Esther. Okay, so then my last question on this topic is just what other support do you need or want around employment for your students? So do you feel like you're getting the help and the resources that you need then? Okay. All right, great. Thanks. Next slide, please. So the next slide is a round of commitments. We did this last time we met, and it's something I want to just start incorporating into every meeting. So I'd like everyone to just either chat or pop up and just give us one action item that you'll be committed to in the next month.
Tapping into that nursing department and getting students to actively respond and participate in services.
Okay, great. I plan to go in and give presentations about our programs in classrooms when I'm at the college.
Great, thanks. Looks like we have some chats too. So Matt has three. attending local technology expo and job fair. Oh, where did it go? Job fair this week to make connections with employers, meet with completing students to discuss employment goals, and promote add-on certificate options to current students. Awesome. Thank you. And Adriana, presenting in a nursing class on resumes and interviews, and letting students follow up with me for individual help. Great. Thank you. Oh, and Natalie, holding office hours for 5 hours, 3 days a week for resume writing support. Great. Okay, thank you. Bye. So this is just a reminder and a follow-up question, and I actually have a poll for you to respond on this one. Can you pull up the PAA poll? So the question is, who has sent Caitlin Jekyll program information for recruiting PAA participants? If you could just respond yes or no. Okay. And then the other part of this is, so if you haven't, the request is please do so. If you haven't sent her information for a long time, please send her updated information. And if you can, let me know, so because I'd like to be able to track that everyone made an effort to recruit PAA participants. Mm-hmm.
summer is changing.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then we said, yes. We said Shannon.
Okay, and since we have a little bit of time, if anyone would like to have any discussion about recruiting TAA participants, open it up for that right now. Can you check the chat box? Okay. Okay, let's move on.
Okay. You want to do it?
It's okay, go ahead and go to the next slide. That was so cool. That was my first time doing a poll. I'm going to be polling you guys on everything now. Can you go to the next slide? Okay, thank you. Okay, so the next slide is really our last slide, and this is to talk about our meeting time, format, and any suggestions for upcoming topics or speakers. So the first question is, I'm assuming this time works for the people who are here, but I still want to ask you the question as well. Does this meeting time and date work for you on a regular basis? Because I'd really like to change the meeting and set it for the rest of the year. It does. Yes. Okay.
Oh, great.
Good. Okay. So I'll just need to check with the few people who aren't here on that. But you can plan for the next meeting. Go ahead and mark your calendars for May 21st at the same time, 1 to 2. And then I'd also really like to encourage other people to take turns facilitating this meeting. I know that in the program managers meeting, that's what they've been doing. So I would really love to change the format so that I'm not the facilitator every time. So is anyone willing to volunteer to facilitate a meeting?
No pressure or anything.
Adriana.
Oh, great. Thank you, Adriana. So, and Brandy's here. What was your point? Something after?
People are volunteering.
Yay! Thanks, you guys.
There's a topic idea, too.
Okay. So we have Adriana, who's volunteered for June or July, and Brandy for July or August. Anyone like to volunteer for May? Okay. Okay. Great. Thanks, you guys. I really appreciate that. And there was a topic idea as well about having the topic be job search websites. Good idea.
I'd like to do best practices of resume tips and know what people, when they're meeting with individual students, what tips are they giving them for resumes.
Yeah, great idea.
Would you like to facilitate that meeting? Not May, August.
Yeah. You got that.
May
August.
Probably,
okay.
August is fine.
I think we've got month. June, July, and August now. Great. Are there any other ideas for topics or guest speakers? Okay, so maybe one meeting on job search strategies, another one on resumes.
Matt suggested how to highlight Health IT on resumes.
Mm-hmm. Great, thanks. And how to highlight Health IT on resumes, that could be part of the resume discussion, I'm thinking.
Mm-hmm.
So, great idea, Matt. Okay, so that's all I have on the agenda for today, so we might actually end early unless anyone has anything they'd like to add. Okay, great. Thanks, everyone. We'll be sending out the notes and recording. All right.
Bye.